Direct from Studio A of the Howell Cheney Technical High School Media Production Shop, it's HCTV News.
Hi, I'm Bailey Norman.
And I'm Tony Collazo. Welcome to HCTV News.
This cycle, Media Production Class of 2014 and 2015, has put together a great episode just for you.
To start today's show, Jesse Guerrero and Brittany Petrescas from Class of 2015 in Media Production had a chance to sit down with the lovely Miss Stack and talk about the recent online smoking cessation.
Did you know that 1/6 of teenagers smoke? Well, this year, a new program at Cheney Tech has started called the Online Smoking Cessation Program. This program is aimed to help students, staff, and faculty put down their tobacco use products.
The program can start anytime the person feels that they're ready to take a look at it. As I said, they can see me and I can give them the information. They can sign up for it. And then they can start it every 30 days on a computer of their choice in the privacy of their home.
Jacqueline Stack, social science instructor, decided to become involved in the smoking cessation program after receiving a notice from central office. The program is a 5-stage program that is completely online.
A student can simply get involved by coming to see me in room 218, and I can explain the confidential online program to them. Absolutely anonymous, confidential. No one knows who is a participant in the program, as well as all the answers and steps that the person that is engaged in the online program is strictly confidential.
Ms. Stack hopes that the program can help members of the Cheney Tech community who may be struggling with the nicotine addiction, as well as raise awareness for the overall problem.
You receive an awareness of the ills of smoking, and perhaps students and faculty that haven't started smoking or chewing tobacco will think twice about that.
Reporting for HCTV News, I'm Brittany Petrasca.
That is one helpful program. If you're looking to quit smoking tobacco, try joining the online smoking cessation. Remember that all information that's submitted is completely confidential. Please see Ms. Stack for further information.
This cycle, we have started a new ongoing segment called Shop News.
We will be keeping up with current events, awards won, new equipment, and student profiles so that you guys will be aware of what happens in everybody's shop around the school.
Recently, two representatives from the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, came to talk to the sophomores in the CAD shop here at Cheney Tech. The students were shown a couple of video presentations. One presentation in particular talked about the building and designing of planes. The FAA representative talked about jobs that are available in local factories. The representative also discussed how some CAD students will be able to have the opportunity to job shadow an employee of one of the factories. One day, they can be making the blueprints for future planes to be constructed.
The seniors in manufacturing are working on a wind turbine that was donated to them by UConn. The CAD shop created designs for the turbine that manufacturing is using to construct it. The turbine was constructed to create an example of a working alternative source of power by powering a light bulb, which is powered by panels spinning around the center of the turbine.
Here's a short piece on some of what's happening these days in electrical. Savannah LeBron has the story.
Here in Media, Electrical is working in our shop, putting up a new on-air light that glows when we are recording in Studio A. They are also working on an apartment in East Hartford where they are fixing smoke detectors, wiring the apartment, and installing new lighting fixtures. Electrical is finishing up work in Diesel where they have been working on a malfunctioning forklift and are just fixing it up the best they can.
In auto news, Dylan Christensen, a senior in automotive, got into work-based learning at AMCO Transmissions in Manchester. Tyler Procaccini, also a senior, got a job at Langdon Volkswagen as an apprentice tech. In general, the auto shop has been very busy with more than 25 vehicles serviced since September 1st. Keep up the great work, guys.
Finally, in the cycle shop news, here's a report from the IST shop.
This year's IST juniors have been hard at work creating their own personal websites.
So far in shop, we're working with HTML to make websites in Notepad from scratch. HTML is hypertext markup language. To prepare for this, we've been doing packages and step-by-step, taking notes and taking tests on our tags to see what we learned so far.
So far in shop this year, we have been working with HTML and Notepad to help us get a basis or understanding of how to create websites. And hopefully we'll be posting them up on the web. We've been working with packets, and we've been reviewing things that we may have learned in present years. Possibly later on this year, we will be able to upload our website to the web, and hopefully that'll turn out really well.
What we've been doing in shop this year is HTML coding and Notepad. What we are doing to prepare ourselves for this is step-by-step lessons in the packets that we've been given by Mr. Knuckle, and we're creating them in Notepad. Personally in shop, I'm creating my own website for beauty and the products that I'm willing to sell.
The outcome of all this training and studying has definitely prepared them for what they have created this cycle. Keep it up, IST.
Recently, Cheney Tech held back-to-school night for the freshmen and their parents.
This year, the media production class of 2014 covered what back-to-school night was like here at Cheney.
Purpose of Back to School Night is open a channel of communication with the parents and also to get a one-on-one type of interaction with the parents so that they can know the teacher and communicate effectively with the teacher. We had more than 300 people in the building that night, and traditionally the largest turnout is the ninth grade parents because they're excited, they're enthusiastic. It's a whole new venture for them. We have the good fortune of open communication with our parents and grandparents and guardians, and this is just one component of it. It allows the faculty to share the curriculum with them. It allows the faculty to get to know them a little bit better. It puts a face with a name and with an email. So we have lots of channels of communication. We go out and broadcast an email. Most of the parents have email addresses. We remind them with postcards. We do numerous mailings to the home so that the parents understand what our goals are for their children's success.
Art is definitely one of the few great electives we have here at Cheney Tech. We sat down with Mrs. Blair, who is going to talk to us about what art is.
Hi, I'm Ms. Blair. I'm the art teacher at Howell Cheney Technical High School. What constitutes art can be interpreted in various ways by different people. And because art is very personal in nature, there is no one-size-fits-all definition. For some people, art is strictly the drawings, paintings, sculptures, etc. that one would find in any gallery or museum. For other people, art is considered to be more of a performance or a process rather than a product. For these people, the act of expression or portrayal of emotion is as important as the finished product. Performance artists actually exist. There is support for the theory that every person's life is a work of art in progress. Each person makes value judgments and decisions regarding how he or she dresses, what one likes or dislikes, and how one chooses to live and interact with others.
Now that you understand what constitutes art, Ms. Blair is going to explain how important art is and the stereotypes of art and how each piece of art is different.
Well, I'd have to say that art has been my whole life since I was a little girl. My mom was an artist. She always exposed us to the arts. She used to just drop us off at the Wadsworth Athenaeum, and we'd just play there all day. So I probably know like all of the paintings. So basically, art is my whole entire life. Well, I don't know that that necessarily is a stereotype. A few students I have seen or have heard from saying that, oh my God, my other art teacher was so mean. Art has always been a lot of fun for me, and I try to make it fun for my students. Art is so severely underfunded, and a lot of it has to do with cleanup, and kids don't take it seriously. So I guess a lot of it depends on the person. Well, I used to think that saying that Van Gogh is your favorite artist was kind of cliche. As long as you're creative, it's all good.
That's really cool. There were quite a few things I didn't know about art in there. Thanks, Ms. Blair.
Time for a short feature by Anthony LaPenna about talented athlete Sherez Allen.
Well, playing multiple sports isn't really bad because, you know, if you're strong mentally, physically, you can do anything you put your mind to. Well, football and basketball are basically the same sport except for the pads and the helmet and a lot of running. But other than that, it's good. Yes, basketball has always been my main sport, so it shouldn't be hard to get back in the groove. Well, without Anthony Gillespie, well, he was a good player, but as a team, if we work together hard, it shouldn't be that hard to fill in the gap. Well, the chemistry we have is kind of fun and also hard working at the same time because on the court, we have to work hard to win a game. And off the court, we can have a bunch of fun, like go out, eat pizza, party. Well, with the team we had last year, this year shouldn't be that hard. Because, you know, we all have been working hard, playing from 9 to 5, just like a job.
Thanks, Anthony. Now for another new program we like to call What Do You Think?
What Do You Think is where we ask students and teachers what they think about some important and not so important things.
I prefer Bing because it gives me more results.
Google because like I use it more often. I never use Bing at all.
I am a Google girl.
I'm gonna say Google. I like the pictures.
It's kind of stupid.
We should be able to use our phones when we want and how we want. Doesn't matter if it's for educational purpose or not. We are designated to come to school. We should be able to do what we want at school.
What I think of the cell phone policy, my true opinion, it's a tease because kids like to be on their cell phones 24/7. Having it for like 2 minutes in the hallway, switching from class or going to the bathroom is not a long enough time.
I think it's about time that we're starting to take advantage of technology that's already with most of the students in a classroom. If you have the cell phone, the smartphone with the access to the internet, absolutely we should take advantage of it, we should use it. It's a tool that you as students are already familiar with using, and it's just careless not to use what's already available to us as teachers.
Well, that's all for today's episode, Cheney Tech. I hope everyone's enjoyed it.
I hope to see you next time. I'm Tony Collazo.
And I'm Bailey Norman, signing off for HCTV News.
Bye.